Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats for the Class of 2020 celebration. We're going to be starting in just a few minutes. Again, please make your way to your seats. We will be starting in a few minutes.
Good afternoon to our Class of 2020 alumni and their guests. I'm very pleased to be here today on behalf of the trustees, regents, faculty, staff, alumni and special guests, and all of us at Mount St. Mary's University. I welcome you to a special celebration event for the class of 2020. I would ask everyone to stand, and for Laura Gomez, Assistant Director of Campus Ministry and Spirituality and Director of Music Ministry, to join me at the lectern for a blessing of our graduates.
It is my honor to celebrate today with you. Through it all, you persevered, and we are so happy to have this special time to celebrate in person with you. You, members of the class of 2020, have been resilient in your ability to carry on and enter the workforce or graduate school in a time of so much confusion and possibly chaos. You have been truly unstoppable. And so let us put ourselves in the presence of God, the source of life, of wisdom, of unifying love for all. We gather in prayer on this joyous day with hearts filled with gratitude, because today we celebrate and honor the courage, the tenacity, the unstoppable resilience of the class of 2020. We thank you, God, for guiding them and holding them in your care as they pursued their dreams of education, no matter what, as well as navigating uncertain times to begin their next chapter. Oh God, our light, continue to shine upon them. We give you thanks, too, for the love and encouragement of family and friends, teachers and mentors, colleagues and benefactors who continue to support their dreams. And we give you great thanks, O God, for the courageous witness of our founders, the Sisters of St. Joseph, on whose shoulders we stand. From 1650 until today, these women show us how to live lives of trust in you, O God, drawing upon your strength for the courage and creativity, even in the most challenging times, to press on to love all without distinction. We ask you now to give the class of 2020 renewed enthusiasm and unending strength that they need to continue to build and heal a world to be ever more compassionate, more just, more loving, and more united. And we lift up this prayer that all may be one. Amen.
Thank you, Laura, for those inspirational words. Now, please join me in a warm welcome for our speaker today, the president of Mount St. Mary's University, Dr. Anne McElhaney Johnson.
Faculty, staff, trustees and regents, families, friends, and most of all, the class of 2020, it is an honor and joy to be here with you today. This day has been long in the making. We have waited 2 years to come together to celebrate our graduates in person. And it is such a gift for us to be here with you today. Today, I have the distinct pleasure of providing a second graduation address to this illustrious class, but I must tell you that this opportunity brought its challenges. Typical commencement addresses often provide words of counsel, words of inspiration to the graduates who are heading out into the world. Speakers seek to give good advice and instill lessons on how to live fully as you take on the challenges of the future. In pondering the lessons I could impart to you, I realized that we are in quite a different situation. You are already out in the world. So rather than tell you all you need to know as you leave Mount St. Mary's as graduates, something you have already encountered in this ever-expanding world of ours, I am turning the tables today because I want to share with you what you, the class of 2020, has taught us. Has taught me personally. I want to reflect on the lessons you imparted to this community in your final year with us. Yours was not an easy journey. Although the first years of your time at Mount St. Mary's was a more predictable trajectory with the challenges of university level work, and for some of you, graduate level work, exams, papers, figuring out time management as you sought to balance studies, clubs and activities, your personal wellness, work-study or off-campus jobs, and for many, family responsibilities. But you did it. You figured out a rhythm that worked for you. You became proficient at juggling responsibilities, and you immersed yourself in your Mount experience, growing, expanding, and thriving. And then your final year arrived with all of the anticipation, excitement, and nervousness that a senior year or a final year of graduate school engenders. You were ready, and you were beginning to look beyond your Mount experience to your path forward with the degree in hand. And then, on October 28th, 2019, Los Angeles experienced the Getty Fire, and your world and ours seemed to turn upside down. The Getty Fire in all its fury changed our reality. The ordinary rhythm of the days, the regular routines and patterns of our lives were upended. Grateful first for the safety of every student, and then grateful for the well-being of the Chillon campus itself, we moved our entire community to the Doheny campus. Our Chillon residential students experienced the joys and challenges of hotel living. Our Doheny residential students experienced tighter quarters as they opened their rooms to their Chillon sisters and brothers. Everyone experienced longer lines at the cafe, while at the same time enthusiastically welcoming the arrival of food trucks on campus. Life at Doheny was busy. The library and classrooms were full, and Chillon and Doheny students lived and studied together with incredible openness and grace. And had our story stopped there, I would enumerate right now the lessons you taught us about flexibility and openness, and your willingness to candidly express your frustrations and your fears, as well as your appreciation of how your faculty and staff moved to support you during this disruption. I would tell you that your strong spirit moved me, and that every day this community tried to honor that very spirit with the educational and personal experience that you deserved. And then I would probably conclude with a few sentences about how good it was to be back to normal in spring 2020 and offer words of appreciation and congratulations to you and your family. But we all know that fall 2019 was followed by the outbreak of COVID-19 across the globe, and during your 2020 spring break, this city, county, and indeed the country shut down, and we were directed to shelter at home. Life as we knew it changed completely again. And you, the class of 2020, spent your final Mount months away from campus and away from each other. Although we met through Zoom and FaceTime and email and social media, it was not the same. We missed you, and you missed each other. And that is when you taught us the most valuable lessons. As it became clear that COVID was not dissipating and your spring term and your graduation would occur virtually, you showed who you were as individuals and as a class. You remained focused amidst your deep disappointment and the fear that COVID brought. You showed us determination, grit, and grace. You expressed your disappointment clearly, but you brought forth the critical thinking skills that you had honed over your years at Mount St. Mary's, and you used them. You understood the science and what it called for. You understood the need for continued separation, and you gracefully helped us figure out how to engage more effectively in remote teaching and learning. You taught us how to show up and to persevere. And although it's not a title you sought, you will always be known as the class of 2020, the class whose lives were interrupted across their senior year, the class that lived through fire and pandemic. You will always be that group of resilient and determined women and men who cared enough about their education and their sacrifice and the sacrifice of their families to keep going no matter the challenge. You inspired us in 2020, and you inspire us now. Look at you. You keep showing up for each other and for your families. It wasn't easy, and yet you are here. 2 years out of college, working or pursuing advanced degrees, here you are, impressive as always. Artist Vincent van Gogh once said, "Normality is a paved road. It's comfortable to walk, but no flowers grow." Class of 2020, yours is a path where flowers will grow in abundance. You are the class of 2020, and although you do not need my advice, I do have a request for you today. The request actually echoes a plea from our provost, Dr. Bob Perrins. Dr. Perrins spoke to the graduating class of 2021, who, though unable to come together in person for their senior year last year, did gather in this very spot for their commencement last May. His words are prevalent on this occasion as well. Dr. Perrins stated, and I quote, "We all know the impact that COVID-19 has had on individuals in our families, our circle of friends, our neighborhoods, and on this city of angels that we call home. As we begin to move forward, I implore you not to forget the terrible impact the pandemic has had on our society and how it has exposed underlying structural problems that must finally be addressed." He went on to say, during these years of the pandemic, the vast majority of people realize that our world and this nation are a lot more fragile, broken, and fundamentally flawed than most of us would like to admit. The COVID-19 pandemic has highlighted many of the problems that urgently need to be addressed and not simply swept under the rug as past generations have done. As a society, we must find ways to fundamentally reshape and even rebuild aspects of our world in order to solve problems related to wealth disparity, inequalities in access to healthcare, challenges related to housing, education, and systemic racism. End of quote. Class of 2020, you all know this. You know this because you are already living and working in this world amidst myriad challenges, challenges that past generations, my generation, have not addressed effectively. In fact, our world has become ever more fragile in this last year. Our democracy itself is at risk. Dr. Perrins and I are bearing the unfair news that it is now up to you to do what we failed to do. It is up to you to change the world. Now, this is a Herculean task, but let me remind you who you are, lest you forget your preparation and your power. You are smart. You are focused. You are incredibly resilient. And because of your experiences, you are wise beyond your years. Your experiences have shaped you, have prepared you for this moment. There was a powerful line from the book of Esther in the Old Testament that is often elicited when describing the need for extraordinary leadership. Queen Esther is called to save her people from death, but at great risk to herself and her family. At the moment when Esther is weighing her ability to change the course of human history, Mordecai, her uncle, turns to her and says, "Perhaps you were born for such a time as this. Perhaps you were born for such a time as this." Class of 2020, you have been through challenges, and nothing deterred you from your dream of a college education or an advanced degree. I ask you to consider, what if you were born for a time such as this? What if you were born all those years ago to lead in this unprecedented time of challenge? At a time when we need the sharpest minds, the strongest wills, abundant courage, and most importantly, kind and loving hearts. You are our hope. You are here for a reason, and it is precisely because of all you have learned and experienced that you are ready. This world needs you, and you, the brilliant, an unstoppable class of 2020, you are up to that task. We love you. We are so proud of you. We stand in awe of you. Congratulations, and thank you for being here with us today.
Honored alums, we had a chance to celebrate your actual commencement virtually in 2020. Today we celebrate you again, but this time in person. I'd like to read this special resolution adopted by the Mount St. Mary's Board of Trustees. In honor of the graduates of the class of 2020, the Board of Trustees of Mount St. Mary's University has approved the following resolution to mark this momentous occasion. Be it resolved that the class of 2020, having shown themselves worthy according to the standards of the constitutions and requirements of the university, were awarded their degrees in a virtual ceremony on August 16, 2020. These Mount graduates have weathered unparalleled circumstances during a global pandemic. The university and the Board of Trustees recognize and celebrate the unstoppable spirit exemplified by this class by returning for this special ceremony to honor the class of 2020 for their extraordinary demonstration of determination, courage, and grace. In witness, therefore, we have subscribed our names and affixed the seal of the university, given in the city of Los Angeles on the 9th day of May in the year of our Lord, 2022, signed by Deborah Reed, Chair of the Board of Trustees, and Ann McElhaney Johnson, President. And now, the moment we have all been waiting for, the opportunity for you to cross the stage and be recognized by the university and your loved ones, both those in attendance today and those watching via live stream. I would like to remind all of our guests to remain in your seats during this time. After leaving the stage, your graduates will have their official photos taken by our photographers, and there will be plenty of time after the ceremony for additional photos. We also want to remind you that for the safety of everyone here today, no one will be allowed to leave the parking area until the ceremony is concluded. Presenting the graduates will be Dr. Ann McElhaney Johnson.
Merla Nerissa Gutierrez, Associate in Arts in Nursing. Alejandrina Hernandez, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology. Isabel Villarreal, Bachelor of Arts in History, cum laude. Marilag Magpante Lubag, Master of Science in Business Administration. Esther Chavez, Master of Science in Education. Lilia Fernandez Gaspar, Master of Fine Arts in Film, Television, and Photography. Martin Urrutia, Master of Fine Arts in Film, Television, and Photography. Cindy Hernandez Salcedo, Master of Science in Education. Cienwin A. Peterson, Bachelor of Science in Film, Media, and Social Justice. Polonia Finau Nevalima Maula, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology. Sienna Marie Miranda, Bachelor of Arts in Film and Media. Jacqueline Juarez, Bachelor of Arts in Business Administration. Gabriela Hernandez, Bachelor of Arts in Applied Psychology. Jaisley Leticia Caballeros, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology. Enjacor Renderos, Master of Science in Education. Karen Edith Barreto, Bachelor of Arts. Karina Regoza, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology. Tisa A. Harper, Bachelor of Arts in Liberal Arts. Richard Charles Wright, Bachelor of Arts in Applied Psychology. Miriam D. Barrera, Bachelor of Arts, Cum Laude. Daniela Gonzalez, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Diva Cairo, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, Cum Laude. Megan Lacerna Egoi, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Ariana M. Arredas, Master of Science in Counseling Psychology. Maria Ines Recinos, Master of Science in Education. Ana Berta Lopez, Bachelor of Arts in Liberal Arts. Patricia Maritza Gonzalez, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Margarita Lechuga Nuno, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, Cum Laude. Ileana Vasquez, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, Magna Cum Laude. Kayla Janae Martin, Bachelor of Arts in Childhood Development. Yesenia L. Ruvalcaba Gomez, Bachelor of Arts in Childhood Development. Azucena Guadalupe Cruz, Master of Science in Counseling Psychology. Natalie Jasmine Acevedo, Master of Science. Sofia Michelle Ramirez, Bachelor of Science in Film, Media, and Social Justice. Ana Maria Villa, Bachelor of Arts in Business Administration. Justine Alexandria Lozano, Bachelor of Arts in Business Administration, magna cum laude. Jessica G. Canizales, Bachelor of Arts in Business Administration, magna cum laude. Vera Espinosa, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration. Cristal Yvette Mejia, Bachelor of Arts in Child Development. Clarissa Amy Reyes, Bachelor of Arts in Business Administration, magna cum laude. Stephanie Castaneda, Bachelor of Science in Sociology. Diana Celine Torres, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology. Jacqueline Ramirez, Bachelor of Arts in Journalism. Lauren Ashley Trinidad Alvar, Bachelor of Arts. Maria Barbara Lainez, Bachelor of Arts in Liberal Studies. Maria de Lourdes Pelayo, Bachelor of Science in Social Work, magna cum laude. Kathy Rincon, Bachelor of Arts. Cecilia Palacios, Bachelor of Arts. Micaela Marie Wong, Bachelor of Arts in Biology. Guadalupe M. Cuellar, Bachelor of Science in Criminology. Liana Kamali Moore, Bachelor of Arts in Business Administration. Carmen Julia Ramos, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology, summa cum laude. Miriam Melissa Urquiola, Bachelor of Science in Criminology, summa cum laude. Riley Tomiko Yamauchi, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, magna cum laude. Brianna Andrea Garcia, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, magna cum laude. Amanda Danielle Wilkins, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, cum laude. Cecilia Ramirez, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Maciel Alexa Argueta, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Ariel Celeste Gonzalez, Bachelor of Arts in Childhood Development. Stephanie Estrada Guzman, Bachelor of Arts in Childhood Development. Nelly Jasmine Oseguera, Bachelor of Arts in Global Policy. Cecilia Elizabeth Lucatero, Associate in Arts with Honors. Anthony David Perlas Tavera, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Justine Hsiao, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Cindy Daniela Tejada, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Giselle Gutierrez, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Paola Graciela Castillo, Bachelor of Arts in Music, cum laude. Natalia Monroy Jogested, Bachelor of Arts in Art, summa cum laude. Simone Amelia Soriano, Bachelor of Arts in English. Katrina Lee Wong, Doctorate of Physical Therapy in Physical Therapy. Luisa Armas, Bachelor of Arts in Film and Media. Jessica Irene Contreras, Bachelor of Science in Biochemistry. Joanna Jasmine Ganara, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology, magna cum laude. Melissa Alejandra Hernandez, Bachelor of Science in Social Work, cum laude. Sonia Lucia Chavez, Master of Science in Education. Christine Villarreal, Master of Science in Education. Brenda Maria Padron Guzman, Master of Science in Education. Daisy Nuno, Master of Science in Counseling Psychology. Sandy G. Morales, Master of Science in Counseling Psychology. Cynthia Beltran Soto, Master of Science. Alma A. Rubalcaba Delgado, Master of Science in Counseling Psychology. Brenda Cabrera, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration. Patricia Salmeron, Master of Science in Psychology. Margarita del Carmen Maria Ramirez Cruz, Master of Science in Counseling Psychology. Juan Jose Robles, Bachelor of Arts in Liberal Arts. Nayeli Dominguez, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology, magna cum laude. Maria Jose Hidalgo Flores, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology. Janelle Annalyn Reynolds, Bachelor of Arts in Liberal Studies. Paloma Flores Hernandez, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Jasmine L. Torres, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology, summa cum laude. Erin Jennifer McCran, Bachelor of Arts in Journalism. Adlicia E. Hernandez, Bachelor of Arts in Gerontology. Nancy Frausto, Master of Science in Nursing. Estefany Mares, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration. Maria Guadalupe Lopez, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Sheila Johnnelly No, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology, cum laude. Crystal Abby Centeno, Master of Science in Health Policy and Management. Maria Avila, Master of Science in Education. Mireya L. Fletes, Master of Science in Education. Christine Andrea Penate, Bachelor of Arts in Business Administration. Rebecca Foldenauer, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology. Brianna Marie Cano Cisneros, Bachelor of Science in Social Work. Brandy Nicole Peterson, Bachelor of Arts in Liberal Arts. Patricia Osorio, Bachelor of Arts in English. Abigail Danan Senko, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Geraldine Lou Lopez Bermudez, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, cum laude. Hannah Nicole Knapp, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Kathy Chen, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Zoe Spears Takakua, Master of Science in Counseling Psychology. Jennifer Valerie Munoz, Master of Science in Counseling Psychology. Lizeth Barrios, Master of Science. Stephanie Nicole Hall, Bachelor of Arts in Childhood Development, cum laude. Gerald Del Pilar, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, cum laude. Lance Marco Lopez Alviso, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Fabiola Moreno, Bachelor of Science in Sociology. Valeria Galarza, Bachelor of Science in Sociology. Dan Reddy L. Jalos, Master of Business Administration in Business Administration. Saul Leon, Master of Business Administration in Business Administration. Erica Leon, Bachelor of Arts in Business Administration. Mayra Alejandra Ornelas, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration. Ashley Melissa Rodriguez, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology. Valerie Ponce, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology.
Before you leave as new graduates, please join me in a warm welcome to Vernice Grajeda, a 2011 alum of Mount St. Mary's University and the president of the Alumni Association Board of Directors.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Vernice Grajeda, class of 2011, and I serve as the president of the MSMU Alumni Association Board of Directors. On behalf of the Alumni Association, I congratulate the class of 2020 on all that you have accomplished. You started your lifelong connection with the Mount as a student, and you will stay involved as an alumni well beyond your 50-year class reunion in the year 2070. Right. You joined a network of 24,000 alumni around the world, committed to using their knowledge and skills to better themselves, their environment, and the world. Congratulations to the class of 2020, and welcome to the MSMU Alumni Association.
Now we have an important tassel ceremony, a ceremony that you all missed when you graduated virtually in 2020. So we're excited to share this with you now. But before I give you instructions, I realize that some of you, being as smart as you are, have already moved your tassels to the correct side. So if you would like to move them back to the right side for this ceremony, you are welcome to. And those who are like, nope, sticking with my graduation from 2 years ago, you are welcome to stick with that. But I'm going to ask all of the class of 2020 to please rise and join in this Mount tradition. And I'm letting your classmates who are coming around just get to their seat. Okay, Mount 2020 graduates. I ask that you formally signify your graduation by moving your tassel from the right side to the left side. If you ever forget which side your tassel goes on, remember that you wear it on the left side over your heart to remember your alma mater. Graduates, please turn and face your family and friends who came to celebrate so they can applaud you appropriately.
We thank all of you for joining us today. Please remain in your seats until the faculty and the administration process from the stage. You may then meet your graduates and begin your celebrations. Once again, let us congratulate our graduates of the class of 2020.
unstoppable. Sooner is the time, but the crest is yet to come.